The muscles of the interior abdominal wall consist of three broad thin sheets that are aponeurotic in front. From exterior to interior, they are the external oblique, internal oblique, and transversus. The rectus abdominis might be the most popular muscle because this is the muscle that makes up the six-pack. The rectus abdominis runs straight down the abdomen and attaches the ribs to the pelvis. It works really hard when you do crunches and sit-ups or any other exercises in which your spine bends forward against resistance. The rectus abdominis is primarily a mover of the spine, but in addition, it helps to stabilize the pelvis and lower back. The external oblique is located on both sides of your waist. This muscle goes diagonally from the back of your lower ribs down to your pelvis. The external obliques on both sides work to help your spine bend forward. The external oblique muscle is a broad, thin, muscular sheet that arises from the outer surface of the lower eight ribs and fans out to be inserted in the xiphoid process. The linea alba, the pubic crest, the pubic tubercle, and the interior half of the iliac crest. The majority of the fibers are inserted by means of broad aponeurosis. The internal oblique is located underneath the external oblique. It goes diagonally from the pelvis up to the lower ribs. The internal oblique muscle is also a broad, thin, muscular sheet that lies deep to the external oblique. The majority of its fibers run at right angles to those of the external oblique. It arises from the lumbar fascia, the anterior two-thirds of the iliac crest, and the lateral two-thirds of the inguinal ligament. The muscle fibers radiate as they pass upward and forward. The muscle is inserted into the lower borders of the lower three ribs and their costal cartilages, the xiphoid process, the linea alba, and the symphysis pubis. The transversus muscle is a thin sheet of muscle that lies deep to the internal oblique, and its fibers run horizontally forward. It arises from the deep surface of the lower six costal cartilages, the lumbar fascia, the anterior two-thirds of the iliac crest, and the lateral third of the inguinal ligament. It is inserted in the xiphoid process, the linea alba, and the symphysis pubis. Although it is the least popular muscle, many think it is the most important muscle. As the name suggests, the transverse abdominis runs across the abdomen. It is the deepest of the abdominal muscles, and since it is so close to the spine, it is the major abdominal stabilizer of the spine. The transversus abdominis does not move the spine forward or help it to twist and rotate. The only function of the transversus abdominis is to stabilize the spine and stop it from moving. Sometimes, the transverse abdominis is referred to as your natural girdle because it acts like a girdle to keep your stomach pulled in. It will work during every movement and every exercise.
Downward
و forward. والعضلة الثانية اللي درسناها اللي هي internal oblique muscle اللي هي تكون upward و forward. وعندنا العضلة الثالثة اللي هي هنا اللي هي transverse oblique muscle تكون افقية يعني بشكل افقي. نفتح هنا الريكتس شيف اللي هي تكون بين الاكسترنال اوبليك ماسل والانترنال اوبليك ماسل. هذه اكسترنال اوبليك ماسل سم من فوق اللي هو ريكتس انتيريور ريكتس ابدومينال مسل وبستيريور ريكتس ابدومينال مسل. تقريبا هنا عندنا باقي الانجوينال كانال في الياف توصل التستس اللي هي سبيرماتيك كورد
بس هذا
هذه غيرناها الخط اللي صار شو اسمه؟
لينيا البا لينيا البا الخط اللي في النص هنا
لينيا البا